Hello, we're looking at how to install Cyberpunk by using Heroic, which is a freeware that you can download and run Cyberpunk in your macOS machine. Just download the stable version, save it into your downloads. From here, you're gonna double click on the DMG, bring it and to the applications folder. And then when it's in the applications folder, run it. You will get a notification that it's something you downloaded, but go ahead and go forward. Then when you're in there, you're met up with the login for the different companies that are integrated. So GOG is one of them. I'm using GOG for the version I bought. You can use Epic Games as well. Then once it's installed, go to your library where your games are, and here I have Cyberpunk, and I'm just gonna download Cyberpunk now into the machine. If you had downloaded before, you could also import the file. So I'll click install and let Heroic do its magic. It will download like if you were already using GOG from beginning. So it's in the library. I'm just going to go into the settings. We're going to do this twice. We're going to run it first standard. You see the crossover version that is there. And I'm going to say install all auto DVIX dependencies and run the game. It will again give some information, and now just click yes. Now the game will start launching, but it will also download all the redistributables that is necessary to run a GOG game and a Microsoft Windows game inside the Heroic. So now the game is starting to launch. Of course, I had to speed up this video, it would be very long for all of you. If you do have questions, just write them down on the YouTube comments and I'll get back to you if I can. So the game will start. I'm gonna go and run the benchmark, standard benchmark, and you will see that in this first run it won't be that fast, and I'll explain what you need to do afterwards. So let it run. Wait for the game to start, do your normal Cyberpunk thing, agree to the license or whatever, and then go into the benchmark just to see how it's performing for you. So what you do is you go into your graphics settings, and you see on the left side of your screen there's a run benchmark application built in, and that's what we're gonna run now. Just setting up here my resolution, that's what I was doing here, just to match the standard resolution I got on my M4 MacPro. There, I'm okay with that. I've also chosen resolution scaling to be AMD Fidelic FX Super Resolution 3 with frame generation, so we get the max from this Mac and the most amount of FPS possible. So you let the benchmark do its thing, and I went up and made this a little bit faster on the video. It will take a little bit longer for you. But you will see the first results are not that great. It's okay-ish, 46 FPS average. But we're gonna stop the game. We're gonna go back to Heroic once more. Alright, so now go into settings. And from settings you wanna click to see Wine Manager. And you see the first on the top there is the game porting toolkit latest, so we want to download that one as well. So click on the little action so that it downloads. now that's done, I'm gonna go back to the game, settings of the game itself, and I'm gonna change the crossover wine version to something newer, because we just downloaded the latest one, and run the game again. Again, the game is gonna just go again and install all the redistributables that needs to be installed in this virtual Windows machine, I would say, or this bottle to be more precise, as it is a wine bottle that we're building here. And once that is done, the game is just gonna start. It will still take more time than what you see here on the screen. And there the game's starting right now, and I'm just gonna basically quickly do the same. I'm going to go to the graphics and run another benchmark for you, and you will see that it's fairly quick on this MacBook Pro. Configuration. So again, just checking everything is according to what I would like. And that's up to you to adjust according to your machine and your GPU capabilities, of course. And then we're gonna go for so I'm leaving maximum FPS open. If you want to limit that to like 30 or 60, it's up to you later on, but this is just to run the benchmark and see how far we can get. Limiting your FPS counter or the capacity to generate frames always helps to make it a more pleasant and stable experience through inside the game. So you can probably limit it at 60 if your machine is up for that, or 30 worst case scenario. And here you see the FPS went up a lot, and we're at almost 84% FPS average, so it's pretty good result for a non-Windows machine. Help me out. If this helped you, you know what to do. Thank you very much. Enjoy.